Now we are going to solve the numericals. Here we can see that the measured value of voltage is given to us. The measured value of voltage is given to us. The measured value of current is also given to us. Measured value of voltage is given to us. Measured value of current is given to us, and we have to find the percentage error of resistance. And before going to discuss this problem, what exactly is given to us? So first we will look at this. This value is your original value of voltage, that's why it will become your original value V. Whereas this is the change in voltage, that is delta V, means it is error plus 5 or minus 5. So this is known as a measured value. Voltage is given by original value plus minus error. Similarly in current, this is the measured value of current. This is the original current I, and this value is your delta I. This is given to us. So when the voltage and current is given to us, and to find the percentage error, we have to find. So how can we find? For that, we will write the formula for resistance. What is that? V upon I. Resistance equals to V upon I. Now what we are going to do here? We know that let me increase one more step. So we have discussed the combination of errors that we have learnt from there. We have understand from there that in division or multiplication, the relative error of resistance will be equals to relative error of potential plus relative error of current. This is we have seen. But because it is asked to us percentage error, हमसे percentage error पूछा है, तो उसको करने के लिए हमने ये values पहले से ही find कर लिए. आ जाओ इधर. This is delta V, this is V. This is delta I, this is I. Put the value. Delta V is 5 upon 100 plus 0.2 upon 10 into 100 plus. What is this? 5%. Okay, leave it. It is 5%, or it will be written as, later on we will write it 5%. If you know that percentage means is always 1 upon 100, so 1 upon 100 can be written as a percentage. This is going to be 5%, this is going to be 2%, the answer is coming 7%. This is your answer. नो सम मोर न्यूमेरिकल्स वी कैन डिस्कस. A physical quantity is related with this. Suppose a physical quantity is given by a cube, b square, a cube, b square upon square root c into d. It is given to us. Now we have to calculate the relative error of this problem. So we have seen that this will be written as relative error in P equals to 3 times relative error in K plus 2 times relative error in B plus 1 upon 2, because root c means c to the power 1 upon 2. I explained to you that for multiplication, for division, for multiplication, always we use plus. This upon plus plus this power comes out. 3 will come here because we have discussed this. If your physical quantity is a to the power n, then z is your physical quantity a to the power n, then we have discussed that relative error of z will be n times of relative error of physical quantity. On the basis of that, we are talking about it. 1 upon 2 relative error of c plus relative error of d. Now from here, what can we say? Relative error of a is given 1%. Relative error of B is given 3%. Relative error of C is given 4%. And relative error of D is given 2%. So here we are getting 3%. Here we are getting 6%. Here we are getting 2% and it is your 2%. Answer is coming 9 for 13%. This is your answer. suppose this is the moon and this is the earth. Suppose the moon is observed from two different diametrical positions, A and B. Like this, it is measured like this, and it is going to subtend some angle theta that is equals to 1 degree 54 minutes. Now we have to calculate the distance between these two is given to us, that is b 1.276 × 10⁻¹. So we have to find the distance. Now we have the formula that b upon theta. But this theta is in degree as well as in minute. फिर डिग्री में भी और मिनट में भी है, तो इसको हम क्या करेंगे, इसको हम रेडियन में चेंज करेंगे. सो पहले इसको हम रेडियन में लिखेंगे. उसके लिए हम पहले इसको डिग्री में बोलेंगे. तो हमको मालूम है 1 degree = 60 minutes. तो हियर थीटा 60 मिनट प्लस 54 मिनट 114 minutes. Now we have the relation that 1 minute = 4.85 × 10⁻¹. 4.85 × 10⁻⁶ radian. So this I told you that in physics angle should be measured only in radian. So here we will be writing the theta as 114 × 4.85 × 10⁻¹. That is going to become 3.32 × 10⁻¹ radian. Now this is the value of b and this is the value of theta put over here, 1.276 × 10⁻¹ upon that is 3.32. Now this minus 6 will go up and it will become 10⁻¹. And when you will divide it, you will get 3.84. This is your answer. Thank you. We are going to start chapter 3. Chapter 3 is all about motion. The branch of physics in which motion is discussed is called mechanics. Mechanics is classified in two categories: kinematics and dynamics. Here we discuss the motion without powers. Here we want to know the with force. So actually, in where we are going to discuss about the motion, motion is discussed in the branch in which the motion is discussed of physics is called mechanics. In the physics ka branch hai, in which the motion is discussed, that is called mechanics. Now mechanics further is classified into two categories. One is your kinematics, another one is your dynamics. Kinematics talks about the motion of an object without knowing its cause. For example, this fan is rotating, means rotating. Why rotating is not important. For example, a car is moving, then you don't want to know that why it is moving. Not interested. Kinematics is not interested why moving. It's moving, it's enough. Then find velocity, find acceleration, find force, find distance and etc. So such a way this kinematics works. But this is our chapter number 3 and this is our chapter number 4. Now to describe a motion, motion is what? What motion ka definition kya hoga? What do you see? This is means change in position. Change in position. But dekhne wala kaun? Time. Change in position with respect to the time is called motion. Now, when a body moves, how many things comes? Distance, displacement, velocity, स्पीड, एक्सेलरेशन, फाइनल वेलोसिटी, इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, what is distance? Distance is actual distance. The actual distance which is traveled by the body. Okay. This is distance. Actual distance, whatever is, okay, it is scalar, means no direction. And its SI unit is meter. Where is the displacement? Is the shortest distance. Actual path length, shortest path length is called displacement. It's a vector quantum. SI unit is meter. Distance is always positive. Or zero. Displacement can be positive, can be negative, can be zero. Means displacement can be positive, can be negative, can be zero. Let's have an example. This is a screen. Now from the form of a word, the distance of school and boy is 5 kilometers. So a boy goes into the in the morning 5 kilometers from home to school, then returns back at 12:30. 6 a.m. 1 p.m. Again it travels 5 kilometers. Now here, what is the displacement? What is the distance? So here, distance, actual path length, कितना गया कितना है एक्चुअल, जो सही है वो बताओ. 5 गया, 5 वापस आया, 10 किलोमीटर. लेकिन डिस्प्लेसमेंट शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ लेंथ बिटवीन इनिशियल एंड फाइनल पोजीशन. नाउ initially in the morning he was here and final point is this. So because in the morning he went like this and afternoon he returned like this, means he started journey at home and finish at home. So if ongoing time the displacement is positive and in return if it is minus, the displacement will be 0 meter. Or you all also can write that in going 5 and in return 5, this is 0 kilometer. Okay. This is something that you must knowing about it.